That's for everybody to hear. I'm a straight man, and there's nothing that can change it.
And spipper stand of spine. I regret doing that very much.
My name is Amigo Montoya.
You know what? You was there tonight!
Hello, darkness, my old friend. I've come to talk with you again.
There's Graham.
They should do theirs!
Jackson took a cookie? No. He's not a theater kid. He can't do that. This is a criminal right here. It's a criminal. He took a cookie from us. Well, he's on stage for this fine and some lights.
Jackson, are you aware that you were a criminal for taking the cookies from the actors?
What cookies?
The one in your hand. Right now that's right below the shot. That one, yes.
I mean, I hunger for human souls.
What are you talking about? You're in jail and you do drugs. This man just posted, "We walk in with Jesus." He is in jail and he does drugs.
Because he will hide. Oh.
You're trying to take a picture of me. I'm gonna kill you.
Back to the stage. Yeah, tree two, and tree three. Best roles in Twelfth Night.
Ouch! Get!
I don't know who's playing the bench, but they're doing a wonderful job.
Wonderful.
Because like those actors in the trees, they're wonderful. But the bench is invisible. Look at him. He's doing such a good order. I don't know who's playing the bench. That bench, yeah, they're doing great. And that bench, I sat on them and they didn't shake or move or say any of the no lines that they have. I would love to be the bench. Actually, the bench is the role I wanted in this production. But I didn't get it, sadly, because I am incapable of being still. Hi, saucy sibling.
Nobody loves me. I'm all alone forever and always.
Siblings, 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 siblings. This is my sister.
This is my brother.
We are siblings and we care for each other. Everything we own,
we always share.
Because we are siblings and we have the same hair.
Divorcing you as my twin.
Divorcing you as your twin. That's okay, you're still married to me.
Do I have to pay that?
Oh, I'm gripping Chon's wrist so I can help memorize my lines.
love some Shake Your Concert.
I would go to a Billy Shakes
concert. Alright, so I'm going to ask you a question. You have to answer it in Shakespearean. What did you have for breakfast?
I know not what I ate, for I ate nothing, and such is my life.
Thine cereal.
Do you like to elaborate on that?
I pourest the milk into thou bowl.
This and is consumed milk. It is milk.
And consumed thy essentials that do make up what breakfast consists of.
Yo, eat it. Wait, a less Spanish.
Thy cold cabinet. I take from it the sweet nectar from the cow to pour into the bowl. But then I take the grain of thy harvest that has been sweetened and pour it into the bowl. But then I take the milk to pour on top of my cereal to enjoy for my pleasure.
I had a cup of blood.
I had it. A toaster strudeleth with frosting, spreadeth with loveth.
I'm so sorry.
Ate my moutheth.
Eggs.
How are you feeling today, Leah? How you doing, Leah?
So Malvolio was just very confused and very pathetic. Van. The van walks through the forest.
I play that classic, my favorite, Ye Olde All-Star by Smash Mouth.
Of course.
Somebody once told me the world was gonna rule me. Now I hate the sharpest tool in the shed. It's wonderful.
You're welcome.
You. Now, tomorrow, if you could spare me, Never Going to Give You Up by Richard Astley.
Oh,
that would be great.
Never Going to Let Me Down. Yes. I know the very tune.
Yes, the very tune. Tomorrow morning.
We are no strangers to love.
So crisp.
He hide. Wow, where's the Grim? I can't see him at all. He's camouflaged himself.
If you throw something at the Grim, I'll be Grim. What is that?
This is the sword for Agucheek. It's called the QWERTY.
This isn't a sword.
This one's so pretty.
Oh, is it just
beautiful sword?
Nice.
Makes big students and little students.
Now,
what think you would really mustaches are?
Methinks it does suit my complexion much.
Wonderful. That's a saucy stash indeed.
Saucy stash.
This has been Mustache Hunter. What's on Abby's phone? What is everyone looking at?
I don't know.
Show me. Abby, would you catch and flip the screen and show us what's on your phone?
I'm
the senior and I'm not the responsible one on this cast video team.
Hey guys, sorry I'm late.
It's okay, Jessa. You are 2 hours late. Why are you so late?
Yeah, where were you?
It's kind of a funny story.
I was in the library, and you guys are not gonna believe what I found.
And what would that be?
This.
Olive Garden.
A tragedy?
By Chilliam Wakespear?
Seriously, guys, this is fascinating. I found this, stuck in between The Chronicles of Narnia and To Kill a Mockingbird at the library. And I was really confused at first, but I started skimming it. And it looks like it's a sequel to Twelfth Night written by none other than Willie Shakes himself.
But it says Chilliam Wakespeare, not William Shakespeare.
Get this. He changed his name so no one would know about his existence.
You see...
But... What? Look. I figured this thing is the only surviving copy.
Hold on.
Nothing.
Well, I think we all know what this calls for. We have to figure out what happens in this thing.
Sir Andrew dies in the first 3 minutes by tripping on a rock!
Olivia and Sebastian found the first ye olde Olive Garden! And they invite everyone to the grand opening! Nice!
Sir Toby tries to willingly not be an alcoholic? What is this? Malvolio poisons Toby's beer, is arrested, and then escapes?
Meanwhile, Mariah's plotting to overthrow Olivia so she can be the lady of the house and commit plans on murder.
And in the meantime, Festy's planning on world domination. He wants to run away with Viola, who is...
Viola's pregnant with Festy's child? Orsino and Viola get a divorce?
Olivia resurrects?
Olivia? My brother, bro, Olivia! Sebastian,
is it Sir Andrew was gay the entire time? They're adding texting to the play?
Well,
burn it.
Glad that deed is done.
I'm just not sure I can move on after what you've done. I mean, I can't stop thinking about it. He wrote that.
Well, let's just forget about it.
Mm-hmm.